The concept of infrastructure as code is to manage infrastructure entirely through code, usually in the form of configuration files or scripts. By infrastructure, we refer to the foundational layers of an IT system, such as servers, networks, and storage. In practical terms, it allows you to write code to describe the desired configuration of an infrastructure. Infrastructure as code tools then automate the provisioning, configuration, and deployment of that infrastructure. These tools can handle nearly any task that can be scripted. For example, they can create and configure VMs, set up databases, web servers, or application servers, isolate systems at the network level, create administrator and service accounts, implement load balancers for traffic distribution, and much more. One of the key benefits of infrastructure as code is industrialization. Repetitive tasks are automated, reducing manual actions and the associated risk of errors. The goal is to achieve faster and more reliable operations. Infrastructure as code tools also allow developers to quickly deploy and tear down cloud resources on demand. This flexibility supports redeploying the same infrastructure whenever needed. Implementing infrastructure as code ensures rapid provisioning of stable environments at scale, improving both the availability and flexibility of the infrastructure. Infrastructure as code also addresses financial concerns, particularly in cloud usage and its pay-as-you-go model. By automating resource management, infrastructure as code ensures that services are used only when necessary. This prevents resources from running unnecessarily, saving costs in the long run. There are two primary types of infrastructure as code: imperative and declarative. With imperative infrastructure as code, developers write code to specify detailed step-by-step instructions to create the desired infrastructure. With declarative infrastructure as code, you focus on describing the desired end state of the infrastructure, and the tool determines how to achieve that state. Tools like Terraform, CloudFormation, SaltStack, and Puppet work this way. Let's look at the differences between the two with more concrete examples. Imagine using an imperative infrastructure as code tool. Here, the developer creates a script to create 3 servers. Now, he wants to increase the number of servers to 5. The problem is that the previous code is no longer useful. Indeed, if we change the number of servers in the first code to 5, it will deploy 5 new servers, which will give a total of 8 servers with the 3 initially deployed. It is important in imperative infrastructure as code to know the existing state before writing a new script. Here, for example, to add new servers in this context, the reusability of the code is rather limited since, in the long term, the code base will tend to grow and become more complex. Now let's move to a declarative infrastructure as code context. Here, the developer only needs to declare the final state of the desired infrastructure, and the declarative infrastructure as code tool takes care of reaching that state. The tool will also be aware of everything that has been deployed in the past. Therefore, to have 5 servers now, it is enough to go back to the same code and update the number of servers from 3 to 5. Here, the code represents the latest state of the infrastructure. So, it is easier to know at a glance what is currently deployed and how it is configured. In summary, imperative models focus on the how, while declarative models focus on the what. Both have their strengths and trade-offs. For instance, the imperative model allows for detailed customization, while the declarative model is more intuitive for managing and scaling resources. Think of baking a chocolate cake. With the imperative model, you provide a recipe with detailed steps for a kitchen assistant to follow. This lets you include specific techniques or tweaks based on your preference, such as a secret ingredient for a creamier ganache or a gluten-free sponge. With the declarative model, you simply ask a chef to make you a chocolate cake. How they achieve the result is their responsibility. You trust them to deliver the final product. In practice, a hybrid approach often works best. You might use declarative infrastructure as code tools for most of your infrastructure, while using imperative tools for specific customizations. A key principle in infrastructure as code is immutability. With immutable infrastructure, Once deployed, the infrastructure cannot be modified. Changes, whether updates, fixes, or other adjustments, are applied by deploying a new version of the infrastructure. This approach ensures consistency and simplifies version tracking. Since nothing changes post-deployment, you always know exactly what has been deployed. Best practices recommend migrating user traffic gradually to the new infrastructure. Once the migration is complete, the old infrastructure is decommissioned. This ensures seamless transitions while maintaining stability and scalability. Thanks for tuning in. If you found this video useful, hit that subscribe button to stay updated with my future videos. And if you think someone else might find it helpful, share it with them. See you next time. Bye.